Welcome back to integralcalc.com. We're doing a U-Substitution problem this morning. This was actually a question submitted by one of our viewers, Anna. And the problem is the integral of 4x over the square root of x squared plus 1. And then dx, of course. The way that I guess that this might be a U-Substitution problem, first of all, I don't know how to just take the integral of this without modifying it somehow. This is way too complicated to just take the integral straight out. I know it's not partial fractions because you can't factor the denominator here. I am going to try to shy away from integration by parts because it's a lot harder to do integration by parts when you have a fraction. It's much more complicated. So my first guess here is U-substitution because you have something more complicated in the denominator here that I'm thinking we might be able to plug U in for. And then I notice if you take the derivative of the bottom, you'll get 2x, which might end up canceling with this 4x. So I'm thinking that we might want to at least try U-substitution. So let's just go ahead and try it. I'm going to assign U to x squared plus 1, and then, once I've assigned u to x squared plus 1 here, of course I need to take the derivative of u, which is going to be du, and the derivative of x squared plus 1, of course, we bring the 2 out in front of the x here, and we have 2x, we subtract 1 from the exponent, which just leaves us with 1, which we don't have to write. So the derivative is 2x. The 1 cancels because the derivative of any constant is just 0. So we have 2x. And then whenever we take du, we always have to remember to just tack dx onto the end here because the whole reason we're taking this is so that we can solve this equation, du equals 2x dx, for dx, so that we can plug it back in for dx up here. So the way that we solve for dx, of course, is by dividing both sides by 2x. So we divide both sides by 2x. Everything cancels over here, and we get dx equals du over 2x. So let's go ahead and plug it back into the integral here and see if we can actually end up simplifying this. So we have the 4x on top. And remember, we assign u to x squared plus 1, so we have the square root of u. And then dx, remember, we solved and we got du over 2x, so we plug du over 2x back in for dx up here. So now this is our new integral, and it looks like we're going to get lucky here, and we're actually going to be able to cancel some things. So you can see we have an x in the numerator and an x in the denominator, and those are both going to cancel. The 4 and the 2, we've got 4 over 2, which will simplify to 2. So let's go ahead and rewrite our integral up here. It's going to be 2, remember, because we've got 4 over 2, and then we have 1 over, so 2 times 1 over the square root of u du. It's our simplified integral. Now, we still want to simplify this a little bit further before we take the integral. The first thing that we can do, we can bring the 2 out in front here. Because everything in this integral is multiplied together, we have 2 times 1 over the square root of u times du. Since everything here is multiplied together, this essentially is one term. It's all connected. And when that happens and you have a coefficient like this, 2 in front of everything, you can move it out in front of the integral so that we don't have to deal with it inside of the integral, and we can simplify. So we're left with 1 over the square root of u du. And now, the way that I like to simplify this, whenever possible, I like to convert fractions to non-fractions because I think it's a lot easier to take the integral of something that's not a fraction. So I'm going to go ahead and try to do that here. And the way that we're going to do that, we know, this is a rule up here, the square root of x is the same thing as x to the 1/2. these are equivalent or equal. So we have 2 times the integral of 1 over u to the 1 half, and then of course du. So now that we have u to the 1 half, we can move this to the numerator of this fraction. And the way that we do that, our second rule here, and I do this kind of conversion a lot, where I'll change the square root to 1 half and then move it to the top to make it easier on myself. 1 over x, let's say x squared. 1 over x squared is the same thing as x to the negative 2. I can move this to the numerator by changing the sign on the exponent from a positive 2 to a negative 2. So I'm going to move this to the top and just make this a negative 1 half. So I end up with 2 times the integral of u to the negative 1 half du. Okay, so now I'm finally feeling comfortable. This is something that I feel like I can take the integral of. Let's go ahead and erase everything over here. So now we're going to go ahead and take the integral, write your 2 out in front here, and then draw a big parenthesis. If you ever bring a coefficient or anything else outside of the integral like this, we just want to write it out and then do a big parenthesis to multiply it by everything that ends up being inside of the integral here when we take the integral. So 2 times, and this is now much simpler. Whenever we take the integral, of course, we add 1 to the exponent first. So negative 1 half plus 1 is positive 1 half. So we go ahead and write that there. And then we always do the coefficient on the term here, which is 1 implied, right? This is actually, 1 u to the negative 1 half. We just don't write it because it's implied. So we have 1, which is the implied coefficient, divided by the new exponent, which is 1 half. So 1 over 1 half. And then, of course, we do plus c. We always add that to the end whenever we're taking an integral to account for any constant that may have been there. So now we can simplify this. We have 2 times 1 divided by 1 half is 2. And then u to the 1 half plus c. So 2 times 2 here, we can say 4. Remember, our rule up here, u to the 1 half is the same thing as the square root of u. So we have 4 times the square root of u plus c. And now all we need to do is plug in x squared plus 1 back in for u. So 4 times the square root of x squared plus 1 plus c. And that's actually our final answer. Just for style points, though, if anyone is interested, the way that we know that that ends up being true, if you ever are unsure and you want to check yourself, let's go ahead and just double check here. So we said our final answer was 4 times the square root of x squared plus 1 plus c. So now we want to double check that our answer is right. And of course, this is the antiderivative of this function here. So if we take the derivative of this function, we should get this back out. And here's how we can do that. So to take the derivative of this here, I'm going to go ahead and convert this back into, remember we said our rule, the square root of anything is the same as that thing to the 1 half power. So we can go ahead and convert this back to x squared plus 1 to the 1 half. We can say plus c here. So now, to take the derivative, we would multiply this 1 half by the 4 out in front, and we get 1 half times 4 is 2. And then we'd say x squared plus 1, and we would subtract 1 from the exponent. 1 half minus 1 is negative 1 half. But then, of course, we have to apply chain rule here because this is more complicated than just x. So we have to multiply this whole thing by the derivative of this inside portion here. And the derivative of this is just 2x. So we multiply by 2x. And then when we're taking the derivative, c is just representing a constant, like 2 or 4, just a number. And of course, the derivative of a number like that is just 0, so the c drops off when we go ahead and take the derivative again. And now we can just simplify this, right? We have 2 times 2 here. Everything here is multiplied together, so we've got 4. We can also bring this x out in front. And then we have x squared plus 1 to the negative 1/2. So remember the rule that we said before, we have a negative exponent here. This term is in the numerator. If we move it to the denominator, we can change this to a positive. You can go from the denominator to the numerator, from the numerator to the denominator, and just change the sign on the exponent. So we'll end up with, I think I still have room down here, we'll end up with 4x over x squared plus 1 to the 1/2. We just changed this from a negative sign on the exponent to a positive sign. And now, of course, we know that x squared plus 1 to the 1/2 is the same thing as x squared plus 1, or the square root of x squared plus 1. So we see that our final answer is 4x over the square root of x squared plus 1, which is our original function here. So we have proven by just reversing this whole process that this is the correct final answer. Just thought I would throw that in there for you guys. Have a great day!